4 years ago, at 5'10", I dropped down to 124 pounds, yet I saw only flaw. Body image held me hostage. My mirror, its accomplice. 3 years ago, binge eating became my medicine. Peanut butter was my drug. With a spoon with my hand, jars finished within minutes. When your favorite jeans don't fit and your jacket hugs a little tighter, do you feel like shit? I've been there. Have you ever eaten so much that you feel sick? I've been there too. Do you ever look in the mirror and not like what you see? I've been there too. Heck, sometimes I still do. It all started 4 years ago. It was Halloween. I was a size zero. She wanted a photo. I still remember that moment. Halloween streamers hung down from the ceiling. I used them to cover my arm so it wouldn't look fat. I used my whole hand to cover my hip so my muffin top wouldn't pour over my costume. I was a size zero, no muffin top, but my body was my worth, and I saw it as worthless, not good enough for a photo. 3 years ago, I would leave my boyfriend's house with just enough time to make it to the frozen yogurt shop I called mine. Choosing food over love, choosing food over friends, choosing food over fun, I would sit in my car and consume a bag of cookies. In the length of a song, the bag would be gone. I disperse the evidence and drive home like nothing ever happened. 2 years ago, I got sick. So bloated, so sick, I didn't want to leave my bed. A new doctor here, a new doctor there. Why couldn't anyone figure out what was wrong with my stomach? Never asking about my eating habits. Never once did they question depression, yet if you would have asked, I probably would have laughed. Unaware of my own body weight fluctuations, unaware of my own inability to express my emotions. Because you see, I consumed peanut butter in an attempt to prevent my emotions from consuming me. I hoped food would numb the pain within me became the pain in my stomach. The pain in my stomach became my excuse not to leave the house. But I started to write. You see, I found a distraction that wasn't a vice. 1 year ago, I started to write. Suddenly, I had worth beyond my own body. You mean I'm not just the skeleton and skin? You mean I am the soul that lies within? I started to write, you see, I found a distraction that wasn't a vice. Today, I write and I can truly see that I am finally ready to be me. I have worth beyond my own body. Maybe you love painting, surfing, loving, or learning. There are plenty of ways to express your heart, and all of them, I tell you, are art. Say thank you a little more enthusiastically. Look up from your phone. Smile. Look into their eyes. This is from your heart. This is art. What are you holding on to inside? Is there a passion, a desire, a drive? When I live as an expression of my heart, I start to feel full. No longer craving confection, I'm filled with connection. No longer a size zero, yes, I have gained weight, yet now I feel weightless. No longer consumed by my flaws. Once false confidence, now fierce courage. There was a time in my life I would have said, yeah, right. But you see, this is my four-year journey, and I have found the light. This is my adventure of self-transformation. I believe the time is now for you to have yours. Hi friends, it's Michelle Marie Miller. Hope you liked that piece. It's called Live as an Expression of Your Heart. It's pretty much my story within minutes. If you'd like to connect with me further, enter your name and email below, especially if you're struggling with binge eating, body image, or a bloated belly. I feel your pain. I'm here for you. I've been there. If you don't see where you can enter your name and email, you probably aren't on my website, so head on over to michellemariemiller.com so that every Sunday, on what I like to call Self-Love Sundays, I will send you a video with inspiration, tips, tools, ideas, products, everything that I use to get me through my adventure of self-transformation so that we can have you have your adventure of self-transformation. So enter your email below and we'll spend Sunday mornings together. Looking forward to it.